In this free video from ITFreeTraining, I will look at moving operational master roles around in Active Directory. To start with, let's start with the most basic setup, and that is one domain controller in one domain in one forest. When you install your first domain controller in a new forest, all five roles will be on that first domain controller. Just to recap, at the forest level, there are the two operational master roles, Domain Naming Master and Schema Master. At the domain level, you have three roles, which are the RID Master, PDC Emulator, and Infrastructure Master. When you start adding more domain controllers to your domain, you may want to move these roles to different servers. Your network layout and hardware will determine where you move these roles to. In this video, I will look at moving the operating master roles from one domain controller to another domain controller. In the next video, I will take a much closer look at which servers you would place these roles on, depending on the design of your network. In the next video, I will also look at which domain controllers you should make into global catalog servers. First of all, I will look at how to transfer the domain-wide operational master roles. This is an easy task to perform using the Active Directory Users and Computers tool. I will now change to my Windows Server 2008 domain controller to demonstrate how to achieve this. First of all, open Active Directory Users and Computers from Administrative Tools under the Start menu. To transfer or view which servers have domain operation master roles, right-click the domain and select Operations Master. From here, you have three tabs, one for each of the three domain operational master roles. These are RID, PDC, and Infrastructure. Once you select the tab for the operational master role that you want to work with, in this case, the Infrastructure Master role, at the top it will show the current domain controller that has that role. At the bottom is the domain controller that the operational master role will be transferred to. Since I am connected to the same domain controller that is holding the role, when I press the Change button, I will get an error message telling me I must connect to the domain controller that I want to transfer the role to. To connect to a different domain controller, go back to Active Directory User and Computers, and once again, right-click on the domain, but this time, select the option Change Domain Controller. This will show you all the domain controllers in your domain. It is just a matter of selecting the one that you want to transfer the role to and press OK. Now that I have changed to a different domain controller, if I once again right-click the domain and select the option Operations Masters, this time the Operation Master role is listed as DC1, and below this is listed DC2. DC2 is the domain controller that I am connected to, and thus the domain controller the role will be transferred to. Once I press the Change button, Windows will confirm that the role will be transferred, and then I will receive a confirmation message that the role has been transferred. When I press OK, DC2 is now listed as holding the RID operational master role. In this case, I transferred the RID operational master role, but the procedure is the same for the PDC emulator and the infrastructure master roles. This covers the three domain-wide roles. Now let's have a look at the two forest-wide roles. To recap, there are two forest-wide operation master roles. These are the Domain Naming Master and the Schema Master. These roles are not used that much, so Microsoft recommends leaving them on the same server for ease of administration. If the network is expanded to a multi-domain environment, normally the Schema and Domain Naming Master roles will be located in the root or parent domain. You can transfer these roles to any domain controller in the forest, so you could transfer them to the child domain like this if you wanted to. Transferring the Domain Naming Master is a similar process to transferring a Domain Operation Master role. The only difference is that you use the tool Active Directory Domains and Trusts rather than Active Directory Users and Computers. To demonstrate this, I will change to my Windows Server 2008 computer and run Active Directory Domains and Trusts from the Start menu. Just like the domain-wide roles, you need to right-click the domain and select Operation Master. This will show you where the domain naming master is located. Just like the domain-wide rules, I need to once again right-click the domain and select the option Change Active Directory Domain Controller to the domain controller that I want to transfer the role to. Once I have selected my domain controller, it is a simple matter of selecting Operation Master and pressing the Change button. Once you have confirmed that you want to move the role, the domain naming role will be moved. The last Operation Master role I will look at is the forest-wide Schema Master. The process of moving the role is much the same as the process for moving the other roles. However, the tool to move the role is not available by default. The tool required is the Active Directory Schema Snap-in. To make this tool available, you need to run the following command to register a DLL required by the snap-in. To do this, I will go back to my Windows Server 2008 computer and open a command prompt so that I can run the command regsvr32 with the DLL name. Windows will give you a message to let you know the DLL was registered. There is no shortcut in the Start menu to run the tool, so I will run MMC from the Start menu. The administrative tools that Windows uses are called snap-ins. This is because you can run MMC and add or subtract any snap-in that you want. It is not uncommon for administrators to add all their favorite tools into MMC and then save the configuration of MMC. Once the configuration is saved, they can load this configuration at any time with all their favorite tools preloaded. In this case, I will add the snap-in Active Directory Schema. It is now available because I registered the DLL. Like Active Directory users and computers and domain and trusts, I need to connect to the domain controller that I want to transfer the role to. Once connected, I can once again select the Operation Master and then select the Change button to transfer the role. Using each of the different tools, you can see which domain controller holds each role as well as move the roles from domain controller to domain controller. Windows also comes with a command line tool that can be used to find out which domain controller has which roles, called dcdiag. If you run this command with /test:, followed by nose of roles holders, this will tell you which domain controllers have which roles. I have added the /vswitch for verbose to give us additional information. If I scroll up, listed here are all five of the Operation Master roles and which domain controllers they are currently located on. This concludes how to move Operation Master roles around in Active Directory. In the next video, I will look into much more detail about which domain controllers you should put these roles on and also which domain controllers you should make global catalog servers. Once again, thanks for watching.